Now that we've wired a single HDMI source in and a single HDMI out, let's get fancy, shall we? Many meeting rooms are starting to deploy multiple displays, and some soft codec applications like Microsoft Teams will soon support these scenarios.
So we'll start by exploring the second output of the decoder. If you visit the decoder's properties, you'll see an option for HDMI output mode. Let's go and add another generic display to our design as a destination for this second output. We'll just change the property from HDMI 1 to both HDMI 1 and 2, and we'll wire it up. You'll notice in the decoder's control panel that this automatically gives you a second section with video routing options for your second outputs. It looks identical to your first output options, except it will have one additional button that says Follow H1. In follow mode, the second output source will follow any changes made to the first output source. This isn't a permanent property, but a dynamically selectable button you can change while the system is live. Also, don't forget that in order to achieve dual outputs on the NV series, all video sources whose AV stream is wired to this decoder will be limited to 1080p 60, which is done through EDID. If your installation needs 4K, you'll want to upgrade the system with a second NV32H. In fact, let's do just that and see what happens. I'll add another to my inventory and configure it as a decoder and assign its AV sources to be the same options I'm getting from my encoder. This means that we are now multicasting our input sources because they're available to multiple different output devices on the network. You can multicast your 4K streams, again, as long as the encoder is only encoding one stream at a time. But if your second decoder selects a different source, forcing your encoder to encode two different streams, well, then it can only encode those streams at 1080p, not 4K. When this happens, an event occurs that's known as a hot plug event, which essentially involves all the handshaking that happens when a source and a display are connected. If your first decoder is displaying a 4K signal when the second decoder requests a different stream, then both devices will experience a hot plug event while the encoder downshifts from 4K so that it can transmit both streams in 1080. If you open the encoder's control panel, you'll see a setting called 4K 60 One Hot Plug Event.
This is generally fine for something like in a conference room where you're selecting inputs at the top of the meeting. But if you're using it for a big all-hands meeting with tons of judgy people, you don't want to interrupt the video feed when a second decoder requests a stream.
We recommend changing this setting to 1080p 60 max, no hot plug events. This will limit all the EDIDs to a maximum resolution of 1080p 60, regardless of whether the source is 4K. This way, all your content will always be 1080, which will avoid any disruptions when your encoder shifts from streaming a single source to multiple sources.
Of course, if you do need multiple 4K sources available at a time, leave this setting on 4K. Then you simply add another encoder to your design. Now each source is being encoded in 4K by its own device, so you don't have to experience any of the downshifting that happens when they're encoded by the same device. Let's look at another scenario. Don't forget that you can also enable one HDMI output from an encoder.
If you select an encoder and look at its properties, you'll see there's an option for HDMI output mode, which by default is set to none. You can set this to HDMI 1 to get a single output from this unit. Note that only HDMI 1 is an option. HDMI 2 is not available when the unit is configured as an encoder. And also keep in mind that the sources available for this output will be limited to the local HDMI inputs. That's because the NV video endpoint can only operate as an encoder or a decoder. So if this unit is already working as an encoder, then it can't decode any of the video streams to deliver to the local HDMI output.
So this option is most commonly useful as a courtesy preview, for instance. Once you wire a display to this HDMI output, you'll see that you have video routing options within your encoder control panel, but they're limited to the graphic options and the local HDMI sources. No AV streams.
And while it's probably obvious at this point, it's also worth a reminder that if you use any of your local HDMI inputs when the device is in decoder mode, those sources are only available to that device because they're never encoded onto the network to be selectable from another device.
In the next section, we'll take a look at what happens when you want to process or route the audio independently of the video. So take a break and come back for the next section.